It's easier to give. My culture and my Bible have taught me from earliest childhood that it is better to give than receive. A strange elixir of pride and humility, there's nothing that brings me that sense of satisfaction as when I'm able to provide for someone in need. I've even started seeing it in my own children. Recently, one of my sons said, "Daddy, it makes me feel so good when I give something to someone." I think it's a beautiful side of our humanity to want to share what we have with others. But there's also a problem. Giving tends to feed a selfish hero complex that lurks within us. We want to rescue, to hand down and help out. We want to be strong, independent, and in control. For us, receiving comes a little harder, doesn't it? It implies weakness, dependency, and need. These are not characters that our culture holds in high regard. We are trained to earn our keep and not accept handouts. The idea of grace is offensive to our rational minds. William Willimon makes the point that the Christmas story is not about how blessed it is to be givers, but about how essential it is to see ourselves as receivers. In the biblical Christmas narrative, our only role is to receive. We respond by welcoming the Christ child and crying, "Thanks be to God for this indescribable gift," and "Emmanuel, God with us." Maybe it is better to give, but only after we have truly identified ourselves as receivers. We need to learn how to be humble recipients of God's gift before we can turn around and offer a gift to anyone else. Our first priority must be that we see ourselves as rescued from exile. Are we willing to see ourselves as needy, as receivers of great gifts? Only then can we turn and offer this gift of grace to others with the true giving heart of God.